Good evening all. Hope you've had a fabulous weekend and a good Monday. I'm feeling rather windswept. Collecting the boys from school this afternoon was very cold. Well, this evening, dinner time, 4:45. Very, very cold indeed and very blustery. Thank you, Beverly. That's very kind of you to say, because I feel like I look like I've been dragged through the hedge backwards. It's the shock. You turn the camera on and looks quite different under the light. I hope you caught the service at the weekend and last night's fabulous tezé. I keep saying tezé. It's tezé. It's fabulous, however we pronounce it. And last night's was, as always, fabulous. And this evening, as we continue, for the final time, pray for the nation in the prayer of the month. I did it. We pray tonight for our schools, colleges, and young people. So join us as we light our candles, our Advent wreath we are starting this evening. Bear with me, don't want to get too close. Oops, remember to tilt the... This is where it all goes drastically wrong. After spending lots of time practicing and setting it up, this is the bit where the small candle melts the big candle and we have a waxy heap. Bear with us, everybody. Thank you, Barbara. As we pray this evening, as I mentioned, for our colleges and our children and our young people, I'd also like you to hold in your prayers this evening my family. My husband's family have lost their Auntie Susan. She died in the early hours of this morning. It's just another blow for everybody. And I'd like you to just hold them in your prayers and your thoughts this evening. And I pray that they will be encompassed by love. They will find support from each other. And I pray that Susan rests in peace, free from pain. We pray also this evening for all those involved in the shaping of young lives. We give God thanks for the sacrifice and commitment of teachers and all those involved in serving young and children and people in education. We pray that all might be nurtured and cared for, and that every needful resource would be made available, that all lives can flourish, even in these difficult times. We pray that no one be overlooked. The Lord Almighty grant us a quiet night and a perfect end. Amen. Our help is in the name of the Lord, who made heaven and earth. Let us take a moment's silence and reflect on the day that we've had, and indeed the day that will follow. Most merciful God, we confess to you before the whole company of heaven and one another, that we have sinned in thought, word, and deed, and in what we have failed to do. Forgive us our sins, heal us by your Spirit, and raise us to new life in Christ. Amen. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Alleluia. Before the ending of the day, Creator of the world, we pray that you, with steadfast love, would keep your watch around us while we sleep. From evil dreams, defend our sight. From fears and terrors of the night, tread underfoot our deadly foe, that we no sinful thought may know. O Father, that we ask be done, through Jesus Christ, your only Son, and Holy Spirit, by whose breath our souls are raised to life from death. And today we'll share Psalm 143. Hear my prayer, O Lord, and in your faithfulness give ear to my supplications. Answer me in your righteousness. Enter not into judgment with your servant. For in your sight shall no one living be justified. For the enemy has pursued me, crushing my life to the ground, making me sit in darkness like those long dead. My spirit faints within me. My heart within me is desolate. I remember the time past. I muse upon all your deeds. I consider the works of your hands. I stretch out my hands to you. My soul gasps for you like a thirsty land. O Lord, make haste to answer me. My spirit fails me. Hide not your face from me, lest I be like those who go down to the pit. Let me hear of your loving kindness in the morning, for in you I put my trust. Show me the way I should walk in, for I lift up my soul to you. Deliver me, O Lord, from my enemies, for I flee to you for refuge. Teach me to do what pleases you, for you are my God. Let your kindly spirit lead me on a level path. Revive me, O Lord, for your name's sake. For your righteousness' sake, bring me out of trouble. In your faithfulness, slay my enemies and destroy all the adversaries of my soul. For truly, I am your servant. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. And tonight's scripture reading, taken from Mark chapter 13. Keep awake, for you do not know when the master of the house will come. In the evening, or at midnight, or at cockcrow, or at dawn, or else he may find you asleep when he comes suddenly. And what I say to you, I say to all, keep awake. Into your hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit. Into your hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit. For you have redeemed me, Lord God of truth. I commend my spirit. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Into your hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit. Keep me as the apple of your eye. Hide me under the shadow of your wings. Grant us your light, O Lord, that the darkness of our hearts being overcome, we may receive the true light, even Christ our Saviour. Now, Lord, you let your servant go in peace. Your word has been fulfilled. My own eyes have seen the salvation which you have prepared in the sight of every people, a light to reveal you to the nations, and the glory of your people, Israel. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Grant us your light, O Lord, that the darkness of our hearts being overcome, we may receive the true light, even Christ our Saviour. Let us pray together for the nation. Loving Father God, be with us in our distress, with our families, friends and neighbours, our country and our world. Give health to the sick, hope to the fearful, and comfort to the mourners. Give wisdom to our front line and key workers, insight to our governments, and patience to us all. Overcome disease with the power of your new life, through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Stir up your power, O God, and come among us. Heal our wounds, calm our fears, and give us peace. Through Jesus, our Redeemer. Amen. And as our Saviour taught us, so let us pray together with confidence. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. In peace we will lie down and sleep. For you alone, Lord, make us dwell in safety. Abide with us, Lord Jesus, for the night is at hand and the day is now past. As the night watch looks for the morning, so do we look for you, O Christ. Come with the dawning of the day, and make yourself known in the breaking of the bread. Restore us again, O God of hosts. Show us the light of your countenance, and we shall be saved. Bless and keep us this night and always. Amen.
Understood, was to understand, to be loved as always just randomly just continues. Whatever we're doing, she just continues. That's better. Thank you, everybody, as always, for joining us. New faces, regular faces. Always, always lovely to see everybody and pray together. If you need anything, you know where we are. If you've missed anything, you can find us on here and on YouTube. Search for Wortley and Farnley Parish. And just watch this space, because there is so much coming on. We've got driving carols, we've got online nativities, online Christingles, messy services, advent trails. It's just endless. And of course, we get back in the building, those of us who feel that we can. We can gather on Sunday, socially distanced, abiding by every rule. But that will be a pleasure to see everybody that feels they can join in. Janice, really looking forward to it. Take care. Enjoy the rest of your Monday evening. And I'm going to go sort my hair out before tomorrow. Good night.